PLA modernization is an issue which has been going on right since the 1970s. In fact, the modernization of the military was one of the first four aspects which Chinese leadership has been talking about in the 1970s. However, we find that there was not much of an impetus given to that issue over the years. And it was only in 2013, after President Xi Jinping, he took over the reins of power in the country and also became the chairman of the Central Military Commission, that we find that the PLA modernization has been given an increasing thrust. Now, the overall thrust of the modernization of the PLA has been focused on jointness, informationization, and the improving the real combat capabilities. That is what the president himself, as the chairman of the CMC, has been emphasizing from time to time. As far as the jointness is concerned, the PLA is now has emerged as a completely joint force. They have got the theater commands, which have been created from the erstwhile military regions. And the theater commands have got the Army, the Air Force, and the Navy, all three integrated as based on the geographic requirements. Now, this is a major issue which has come up at the high level of jointness, which has come up as far as the PLA is concerned from the modernization point of view. The second aspect of modernization, which has been pushed by the President Xi Jinping, has been creation of two very important forces. One is the strategic rocket forces and the strategic space and the cyber forces, which have been combined into one command as such. Finally, one would say that as far as the emphasis on combatization or training for a combat role, keep training from the realistic point of view, is another thrust which the president has been giving, and now this is being implemented very rapidly as far as the PLA is concerned. Let's talk of specifically in the Tibet or the Western Theater Command, as it is known as presently. Here you find that there has been rapid development of infrastructure, particularly military infrastructure. There has been integration of the forces. The PLA Air Force in particular has tremendously expanded its infrastructure and carried out deployments there. You have large number of joint exercises being carried out. So that is something which we have to see with a lot of interest. Now, this modernization has been very effectively supported by China's indigenous military production capabilities. And particular reference, one must look at the PLA Navy. The PLA Navy is today having a large number of inductions. Almost every month a new ship is being inducted with a capability which has been modernized and upgraded. And because of this, again, it is attempting to dominate the oceans, not only the South China Sea, but the Indo-Pacific or Asia-Pacific, as the Chinese would like to call it. So I think these are the broad areas in which modernization is taking place. And India has to watch these developments very carefully and try to see how best we can envisage our own capability development.
Well, in December 2015, the Chinese government had initiated the comprehensive deepening reforms in the military. That included number one, joint commands establishment; number two, in terms of reorganizing the military regions into what they call as battle zones; thirdly, reorganization of many command structures into the general office of the Central Military Commission; and finally, in terms of the integrated joint operations. By 2021, they wish to finish this PLA modernization program. In terms of India, the impact of Western Theater Command, which integrated both Lanzhou Military Region and the Chengdu Military Region before, these will have some substantial consequences for the Indian security. Number one, the Tibet military command has been the only military command which has not been integrated with integrated into the civilian aspects. Instead, the Tibet military command has been given combat duties, and in terms of training program, there has been an enhancement in their prowess. Number one. Number two, the deployment patterns, such as the new equipment, in terms of the UAVs as well as new tanks or artillery equipment, this has been a new trend. In addition to the J-20, Z-20 helicopters as well as the UN-20 transports, These three have been new additions in the Tibet military area. This suggests that the preparations China is actively undertaking in addition to the structural reorganization of the forces. Although the priority of China is still in the South China Sea and Taiwan Straits, in addition to the Senkaku Islands administratively held by the Japanese, still there is a certain modernization that is being carried out in the Tibet region. This suggests that despite the talk about the CBMs and so on, the Chinese have been enhancing their conventional and strategic modernization in Tibet region, especially in terms of the missiles and the rapid response forces and information warfare activities. There has been a huge concern in India about the military modernization of China vis-a-vis India.